So in this session we will learn how to do the harmonic analysis of a cantilever beam. We will require the two solvers in order to perform the harmonic analysis. First one is model solver, and then we will use the harmonic response solver. So to select the model solver in the analysis system, go to the model and double click on it. Okay. Then in this model solver, we have the seven steps. The first step is to select the engineering data that is primarily used to assign the material to the geometry. In this case, we will use the default material of structural steel. In the next step, double click on geometry and wait for design modeler to open. Before creating the geometry, we will select the units as millimeters. Now to create the geometry of cantilever beam, we have to first of all draw its two-dimensional sketch for its cross-section on one of the given planes, that is XY, ZX or YZ plane. I will select XY plane, right-click on it and select look at, select sketching. In the draw toolbar, select the rectangle tool and place the rectangle, and I will dimension the rectangle using the dimension tool. Select the vertical edge. I will dimension it as 15 millimeters. Then select horizontal edge. Let us say it is 100 millimeters. Now we'll constrain this geometry about the XY axis using constraint toolbar. Select symmetry constraint, select the vertical axis and the two vertical edges. Then again symmetry, horizontal axis and two horizontal edges. Okay. Now the sketch is fully constrained as indicated by the blue color of all the edges of the cross section. Let's go to the modeling, expand the XY plane, select the sketch, select extrude tool, apply the sketch to the geometry and change the depth of extrusion, say to 500 millimeters, and generate. Okay. You can rotate the geometry and check, as we have done. So this is the cantilever beam of cross section 100 by 15, and length of beam is 500 millimeters. Next, I will choose this face as the sketch plane. Select face selection filter. Select the face and say look at. Go to sketching, select rectangle tool from draw toolbar and place one rectangle over here. Now let us constrain this rectangle using constraint toolbar. Select coincide, select this edge and this one. Then this edge will coincide with this. I will dimension this feature. So vertical length between these two extreme edges, let us suppose it is 45 millimeters, and vertical distance between these two edges as 15 millimeters. Go to modeling. Expand plane 4, select sketch 2, extrude, apply the sketch to geometry and set depth of extrusion as 30 and generate. Just rotate the geometry and check. So we have added some mass at the end of this cantilever beam. So this completes the geometry of cantilever beam. So we'll close this into phase. Next we'll create the model for analysis. So double click on model. Select the geometry, click on the solid and check the material assigned. So assigned material structural steel, the default material. Click on the mesh, we'll update the default mesh. Okay, now you can control the mesh sizing or mesh properties. Over here in the details of mesh dialog box, you can change the relevant center of mesh to coarse, medium or fine. Let us test. I will select the medium relevant center and update the mesh. It will refine the mesh by resizing the elements. Okay. I will keep it to the coarse. So that will take less time for the analysis. Okay. Next, go to the model, right click, insert the fixed support. For fixed support, let us select this face and apply the selection to the geometry. So this is the fixed support, left hand face of the beam, and then simply click on the solve. Click solution. Now the solver has solved for first six natural frequencies and the corresponding mode shapes. Okay. If you want to change the number of natural frequencies, go to the analysis settings, change the number of maximum modes to fine. I will decrease it to 4 and click on solve. Now it will determine or solve the model for first 4 natural frequencies. You can see here in the table. First frequency is 37.01 Hz and fourth frequency is 384.79 Hz. Now to generate the mode shapes for all these first 4 natural frequencies, right click over here and say create mode shape results. Now these 4 mode shape results are highlighted in the model tree. Now to solve for these results, click on solve. So this is the first mode. Then check the nature of mode is bending. Second mode, it is of sliding. Third mode is of bending again, and fourth one is of twisting. This is bending. Second mode is twisting. Third mode is again bending and fourth mode is of twisting. Second is of sliding. Okay. For first mode, maximum deformation is 0.67873 meters at the frequency of 37.01 Hz. For second mode, maximum deformation is 0.6744 meters for the frequency of 238.66 Hz. For third mode, maximum deformation is 0.58 meters for the frequency of 246 Hz. And for the fourth mode, deformation is 0.97 meters for the frequency of 384.79 hertz. You can view the results in viewport simultaneously. Click on the first viewport and select mode 1, second viewport, select mode 2, third viewport, select mode 3, fourth viewport, select mode 4. So all these four windows will show the corresponding frequencies and the deformations for individual four modes. Okay. So this completes the harmonic analysis. So we'll close this window. This completes the model analysis. Now for harmonic analysis, we'll select the harmonic solver, drag it over the model solver up to the step number 4. So data of these three steps is copied as it is in the harmonic solver. Click on the double click on the setup. You can see harmonic response solver is added in the model tree. For harmonic analysis, we will copy the fixed support as it is from the model analysis. So you can see this edge, left hand side edge is fixed support. Select harmonic response and insert the force. We will apply the force on this face. Apply the selected face to geometry. Now we'll change the force to the components. So this is the y-axis. We'll apply the force along the y-axis. So I will select y component. So minus 200 newtons. Okay. So now you can check A is the fixed support and B is the applied load in negative y direction. Then go to the analysis setting and select the maximum frequency range. For that, we'll check the maximum deformation in modal analysis. The highest frequency in modal analysis is 384.79 hertz. So in analysis setting of harmonic response, I will give the maximum range as 500 hertz. We'll change the solution interval to 100 and solution method to full. Now in damping controls, we will provide the constant damping factor as 0.02. We are studying damp vibrations. And in solution, let us insert frequency response of deformation. It will plot the graph of amplitude versus frequency. Let us select the geometry, okay, and say apply. We will select the whole geometry. See, apply. And we applied the force in y direction, so I will change the orientation of directional deformation to y, okay, and spatial resolution to maximum, okay, and then click on solve. So these are the results of harmonic analysis. We'll get graph of amplitude of oscillations or vibrations versus the frequency. From this you can interpret the results maximum frequency, maximum amplitude of 3.95 millimeters is occurring over here in between 5 to 100. Let us check the value. It is 3.95 millimeters at 35 hertz. So the peak amplitude occurs at 35 hertz. We get one more graph of phase angle versus frequency, and you can see the maximum phase angle is 157.84 degrees at 5 hertz. Similarly, you can insert stress, strain, velocity or acceleration. Let us insert acceleration for frequency response. Select the geometry to evaluate the results for. And then apply the selected faces to the geometry. Change the directional acceleration to y and spatial resolution to maximum and click on solve. Now we will get the graph of acceleration on y-axis versus frequency on x-axis, and you can see peak acceleration is of 237.23 meter per second square over here, and that occurs at 40 hertz. You can extract the results in report preview. Solution. So here are the results, and these are the two graphs. First one is amplitude versus frequency, and second is acceleration versus frequency. Thank you.